Hey guys, Almost Addicted here, and today I'm going to show you how to build a realistic modern mansion in a futuristic style. It's a bit of a different kind of style that I usually do, but I thought you guys would enjoy it. So yeah, I'm going to show you around. I've done most of the exterior, so we've got a nice swimming pool here, and yeah, it's just a really nice design. Even the back looks nice as well. So yeah, we've got a nice backside balcony. We've got two balconies even. We've got a few floors. We've even got a top room where maybe you could do some storage or something like that. So yeah, I'm going to teach you how to build this today. We've got a nice little balcony area where we've got a nice little table and chair design. And then round here, we can kind of go around here where we've got a nice sugarcane farm. This takes us on to kind of this level where we can go down here. If you want an interior design, I will do a video on that. We've got some understair space. And then if we go through here, we can actually get to the top through the roof there. And we've got a nice little kind of room here as well. But also you can kind of use this design here, which can be used as stairs going up to the top balcony. And then we've got a nice little room here. And you can get up and down both sides. So not only does it give it a futuristic look, it's practical as well. So you can kind of use that. So yeah, if you want to get onto this top bit, you can actually do and jump down this way, but we do actually have a doorway. So we've got a doorway here, and then down here, I need to make, in fact, that's the way that you get down there. I forgot to fill that in, sorry. So yeah, you can use this stairway to actually go down, and this brings us onto this bit here, and then you can have little windows here, and then this will bring you onto this back balcony, which will take you onto this room. And yeah, we've got a nice little front balcony there as well. So there's plenty of room in this. It's got a really nice, sleek, modern design. And yeah, it's just a large modern house that hopefully you will enjoy building. So I'm going to do this block for block. It's all a block for block tutorial. So if you could slap a like on the video, and if you've only just come across my channel, make sure you subscribe. And if you hit that bell button, it'll make sure you get notifications. But yeah, I've even done like little designs like this. So I'm going to quickly show you what it looks like in the default texture pack. This is in the Flow HD, but it's just a HD version of the normal texture pack. So yeah, so as you can see in the default texture pack, it looks pretty much the same, if not better, I think. So yeah, but I thought I'd do it in the Flow HD. I kind of liked it. So yeah, I've got a nice swimming pool, and yeah, let's have a look around the back. And yeah, you get the idea. So it's just a really nice, sleek, cool design, and hopefully you enjoy. So without further ado, let's build this and just slap loads of likes on this video. Like I said with the other build, I will be doing the interior. So if we get 2,000 likes on this video, I'll do a full interior, nice, really modern. I'll take my time with it, make sure it's perfect. So yeah, without further ado, let's build this awesome house. Right guys, so I'm using the Flow HD texture pack, but as you can see, it looks like vanilla, so you can just use vanilla if you haven't got this texture pack. It's pretty much the same, it's just a bit more HD, I guess. It's going to fit in a 36 by 35, it's kind of like a large mansion. I've just kind of outlined it in this. I'm going to try and make it slightly realistic, so like a realistic modern mansion of sorts. So yeah, I'm going to count 1, 2. Best not doing it. These are placement blocks anyway. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And then to the side. 1, 2, 3. And then we're going to place our first stone stair like that. So we can just remove all this. And that's going to annoy me. So I'm going to have to put that back. I'm going to turn this down. Right, so let's get rid of this. So in between here, there's going to be a gap of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. And then we'll place another stone like that, stone stair. So I'm going to do one side and speed it up for the rest, or the other side even. So what I do here, just do it on that one as well. So yeah, so we're going to place a block here, 2, 3 like that. So like a stairs, and then add the stairs to it like this. And then we're going to have to do it like this. So it's kind of like diagonal, like this. So we add another like that. So far we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, then 6, 7, let's see, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Let's go to 13 here, like that. Now, underneath here, we're going to start our first block here. So we're going to place that. And then we're just going to kind of just do exactly the same. But just placing enough blocks so we can have like that going up like that. So it should be like that thickness all the way through. So it should be 1, 2, 3 blocks. And then either side, we've got that. So, yeah, I'm going to do that on the other side. And hopefully this turns out all right. I have no clue what it looks like. I've kind of got an idea in my head what it might look like. But that doesn't always work out. I should really pre-plan these. But sometimes I kind of just like to go with the flow of it and see how it turns out. Because sometimes you get some of your all right creations from doing that. So I've done that. I'm going to speed this up and do exactly the same on the other side. So yeah, just repeating it over there. And yeah, I'll come back once that's done. Right, so I've done that. Hopefully they're the same size. What you can do at the bottom as well, just so it kind of looks like it's kind of supported a bit more, you can do this. So just get the stair and turn it this way. And yeah, it just looks like it's got a bit more of a foot kind of supporting it there. Okay, so now I'm going to have, I think the best thing to do is count up 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, maybe 6, and then place it on this block here like this. So it should go across like that. We've got plenty of space underneath and some space at the top as well. Might actually make that higher though, but yeah, for now it should be okay. And we're going to go up height wise. In fact, we'll bring it out first. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 maybe. So it's just past there, and then we're going to square this off. This is the smooth quartz I'm using, but you can use any white block of your choice, so it doesn't have to be in here. So yeah, if you want to use wool, it depends what you're in really, if you're in survival or something like that. And I will do my modern mansion that I was working on. I will do the interior for that, but obviously I don't get many people watching the interior ones, so yeah, but oh well. Right, so I'm going to go up 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, let's have a look, maybe 6 I think would be perfect. So 6 height on that one, and this is going to go back here, and then we can rest it going up and joining to this. It's obviously going to be going a bit further back because I kind of want this as part of the build, so this will be kind of coming back here, and we can maybe have it sticking out the other side there. So I maybe we go to this end block here for now, and then we can always decide to bring it back even more at a later date. So yeah, bring this all the way back and then bring it down like this. Same with this, just squaring it all off. We've got a nice square, should be easy enough. And then up here like that, so it should look like that at the back. And yeah, so we've got that so far. Now at the side here, we can just fill it in for now. So if you want to, I think I'm going to do it this way actually. I'm going to use a little bit of world edit. So we're going to fill in all the sides of this box. So it'd be /set smooth quartz maybe. Smooth quartz. For now, even the bottom and the top, just all filled in, all the sides apart from obviously the front and the back. Or the back and the front, whichever way you're facing. So like that, and then of course the roof. But we can always take blocks out later to add a little bit more detail if I don't feel it's got enough detail. So we should have a cube like that going through. And yeah, so it's looking all right so far. So yeah, I think I'm definitely gonna have it coming out the back there. And yeah, so from here, we count. So this is the front here. We go around to this side. We're going to count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 gaps and then diagonal out to this side using the spruce then. And this spruce can maybe go up 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 maybe for now. And then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. And bring that up. And of course, we'll just put it across the bottom here we'll square all this off and we can always make it better. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. Bring that up and across the bottom as well. Like that. And then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. Bring that up. We can bring this up as well. And over. And like that. And then maybe we could have our doorway here. We could maybe have a little window there. A little A for almost addicted maybes. 1, 2. 1, 2. 1, 2, 3. And then go over the top. Have a 2 gap there. Fill that in. This is going to be kind of part of the inner walls. And then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And then 1, 2, 3, 4. Close this together. And yeah, we can put this all the way across. We might take out a little bit for the door, but I kind of want a staircase going from here through the front door and the staircase starting maybe. Maybe we can have the door in here instead. Just have that across there. And then we can have the staircase going up from there. So I might do the stone stairs starting from here. Maybe a little door in here as well, so we can actually get underneath the stairs. And obviously to get into this area here, we might put a door there, something like that. Could maybe have two doors like that. I think that could work. And fill this in. Same as the other side there, so it's kind of like this. And then yeah, so you can put stairs under, but if you want to save on resources, you don't have to. But I kind of want to see how these stairs will look first of all before I start bringing the other walls up, for it all to fit together kind of thing. Like that, I think it should just about work. Like that, and then we're on that floor level for that one, which is perfect. Maybe put a doorway here, maybe a 2 doorway here or something like that. Bring that up so we can get through and walk through to that doorway there. And then perhaps we can get some stone just to there. Now these will be coming up like this, so we might as well fill all that in. This to here as well, just fill all that in for now. We can maybe add some windows later, but filling it in plain, you've got a blank canvas, so to speak. And then yeah, you can kind of go from there, see what will work after. Because sometimes even just keeping it plain like that does actually work, but maybe you want some windows in underneath here. But we'll do that a little bit later. It shouldn't be too much that we have to take out of the build. Maybe just do one doorway, because this is going to be up like this, so we might as well bring it up to the same height. And yeah, I'm kind of wanting this, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, maybe just one above that like this. And then we can decide to add some windows in here. Maybe we could do something like this, so like window there, and then we've got another 2 window here like that, and then another 2 spaces, and then we can have the last 2 window here. And then you can fill that in with whatever glass you like. I'm gonna go with the black stained glass, but you can use the white stained glass or something like that. So yeah, that'll do. Maybe have it fully plain here, so we can bring this back. Maybe do the same thing with the windows. I'm gonna fill this in actually. Fill all this in so you can pause the video. Slash I set, I think it's 5/1 maybe. slash set 5, not 6/1. There we go. Now I've just got loads of these things hanging about. Let me just pick them all up because that will be annoying. Right, so yeah. Fill that in as well. Bring this up, and yeah, this will go across here, so all at the same height kind of thing. And we can actually do the windows the same, so whatever windows you've done there on the inside here, we can fill this in as well. So if you want to fill all that wall in like that, and just fill it all in. But yeah, as it comes to the windows, you can kind of try and get away with, we'll have a 2 window there, and then it'll be the 2 gaps. And then can we do a 2 window there? Will it affect that? No, it won't. So perfect. And then just dig into here, and then yeah, so something like that. And then we can still get it in, so the black stained glass here like this. And then, yeah, just fill the roof in. Maybe just nice and plain. But if you want in kind of like a skylight, you can always take it out. I'll probably use some blocks for this. It'd be nice, clear block, something. You can maybe take a stripe out like that, something like that. You can decide to do what you like. If you want to keep it plain, you can keep it plain. There's no right or wrong way for that. So, yeah. So we've got that there. Now, should we work on this bit maybe? Because I'm kind of tempted. So keep that plain like that, but I kind of want this. Okay, let me try. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Like that. And then height-wise, so that's 3, 4. Yeah, maybe about 5 high there. Add a 6 one, like that. Yeah, and then bring this over. In fact, I need to count that for you guys. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Bring that across. And then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Bring that across. And then we can bring this across so it rests into the building. And then let me get that and that across here. Okay, so this is where it starts to get like, kind of wanting it to be like, let me see. I kind of want it to kind of push back, so it's going to be kind of like a weird shape, this. So maybe bring it out by 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Maybe out by 4. I think that'll work. 1, 2, 3, 4. And then we can put our stair here, which is facing this way. Like that. Yeah. Then 1, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4. And then we can add our stairs. Going up like this. Bit of a strange one, this one, to try and figure out how to do, but I knew I kind of wanted this sort of shape, but yeah, and then maybe add another one here. Okay, so the back here, we're gonna add a block, and then this block is gonna go over to here, like that, and then we add this across, and then do it at the bottom here. And then we can fill this in like this. I just kind of wanted to make it a little bit different from the normal modern houses. Maybe we could do this as a balcony, so kind of like that as a balcony there, and then this at the top extra here, like that. And then behind here, we can do this. And then maybe instead of that, we could have a block. So we can get some black stained glass as kind of like a balcony. If that makes sense. I wonder if even just that would work, but kind of doesn't. So we'd have to curl that in, see if that would work like that, maybe. Yeah, something like that. So the balcony is just a little bit different. Or maybe we could get some bush there, actually. That might be. Just see if it works. Maybe some just bush under here. Maybe a block for these parts where it's coming down on that bit. Something like that. You get the idea, anyway. So yeah, something like that. And if you want a little bit more space, you can always take that off the top there. That doesn't have to be like that. Yeah, so yeah, I'm going to bring this back now. So it kind of fits into here. And then this going across here. And up like this. Bring this one up as well. Then we can figure out what would be the best protocol for that. I might actually fill it all in for now. So maybe from here to here. With the quartz, just so it's all in plane. And then, yeah, underneath here, I kind of wanted this coming down to 1, 2, 3. Three for now. 1, 2, 3. Same with this one. So from about here, I think, maybe there. So two from that, and then one from that. 1, 2, 3. Same at this side. 1, 2, 3. And the reason I've done that is because, let's bring this, I'll bring it one more down actually, in fact, on each one, because I kind of wanted it to be a level up, in a sense. So it will have blocks underneath that. Might do it in the stone. So like, there'd be a stone underneath here anyway, because this is all going to be kind of like flooring. So like underneath here, like that. We can actually bring, and take that out like this, and just bring it all the way across, and maybe having it wrapping round just for now. This of course can be across, and then we can bring this stone across. That is glass, not stone. Bring this stone across like this, and I'm going to have a bit where it goes down now, around this sort of area, because you want it kind of down, maybe this going across here first, either side, and then have like stone stairs coming down at this point. Maybe would probably be the best point. So grab stone stairs, bringing them down here, so that's how you get into that area. This underneath here, at this point, we can bring it all the way across, and kind of just like it's wrapping around this whole thing here, like that. And then we do one extra, because this is going to go all the way around the actual build. So it's kind of like it's on a podium of, or something like that. Yeah, I'll just square it all off, and when it gets to this point, kind of wrap it in. And then this going across here, and this wrapping around like that. So yeah, kind of like that. Do you know what I mean? And then we can add extra bits where we can put the swimming pool in and stuff then. If that makes sense. So yeah. So here, we can maybe add some stone and have this as a window. So get this window in here. You can maybe put a doorway there if you'd like, but I think there's a nice window there. Would be nice, nice and modern. Same for here as well. If you're wanting to kind of keep it modern and keep it like it's got something going on here, some nice windows here, like that. I think that looks nice and sleek. And yeah, across here, do the same here, this going across here, and then I kind of want a little bit back, so maybe two space there, and we can get our stone going up here, something like that. And then maybe we could have this going across like that, and then we could have, of course, just kind of fill all this in, and then we'll have a doorway in here. Of course, I'm just going to fill it all in plain for now, and then I'll take the doorway out after. Wait, let me. So maybe the doorway be in the middle. You can maybe do it three high or something like that. Wait, three high. Something like this. Take that out, and then you can kind of add whatever you like. Maybe you could add spruce like that. Get a spruce kind of thing in, and then it's just kind of like little opening doors. Like that. Add some bushes in there as well for the kind of front. More for fancy, really. You can't really get out, but yeah, you kind of get the idea. But if you want a little bit more room, you can always bring that out a bit more, put that more on the front, or you can push that back a bit more, or you can just not have the bushes altogether. But you get the idea. Yeah, that was more for just kind of like keeping it fancy, you know. Same with this. I think probably, where's that? Where, 1, 2, 3. So count 1, 2, 3. On the fourth one, we should have the stone there. So that would probably be a perfect place to just take that out. So that one's kind of filled in with stone. Maybe you could have another one next to it with glass in it. So, like that. Do the same at the other side as well. So count 1, 2, 3. On the fourth one, we should have the stone. And then we've got our glass here. This one. Nice and sleek so far. Looking good. Looking very nice. On top here, I kind of wanted some kind of balcony. So we can fill all this in. So let me just have a sip of my coffee. Very nice. Yeah, kind of like we can have something up here. Or can have a ladder perhaps going up to here. But that would take us to this. Which, yeah, I guess that's a perfect point as well. And I guess we could have windows in these little bits. So maybe all the way along, actually. I wonder how that would be. Or how that would look. We can take a quick look, see if it works. Door wise, I'm just going to use anything. Maybe a spruce. Something like that, you know. Of course, you're going to have a ladder coming down from there. It's a bit of a strange house, but yeah. I thought I'd just add some quirky features to it. So, like, that goes up there, so you can kind of get up to the top here. I could probably put some more levels actually at the top here because we're not using all this space. Could maybe have a top level here, and yeah, that's probably about the perfect level. Something about here, and then yeah, you can kind of get onto that level through here, and yeah, you can go through that door or not. Or you can have it just going up into this area, have that as a window, and have the next one as a door. But you can have it kind of like this kind of thing. Then you can just have your door there, and have it like that. Can you get out? That's the question. No, you can't. But you get the idea. You can just have it there instead. Like there. And yeah, so if you put the door from here, it should fit on from this side, sorry, like that. Your door's kind of a little bit out like that, but you can go something like this so people kind of know where the doorway is. Like that. And then if you would like, you can kind of get some spruce or something like that just to make it seem a little bit more like a door area there, something like that. But yeah, and what you can do with that as well, you can actually wrap it around here. I just want to see what it looks like first. But of course, you know, this can be used as stairs as well, which is part of the design, but I kind of don't want it in the way. Do you know what I mean? So probably best to not do that actually. But you kind of get the idea of different stuff that you can do. But for that there, see, yeah, this is the perfect place where we can have, it looks like it's part of the structure, but you can still get onto everything you need around here. So up here, we can have kind of like a garden area or something like that. You can put something on the roof. And yeah, I kind of feel like we could maybe, I don't know if it'll work, but it might be worth a try. From where this window starts, but maybe inwards. Maybe that'd be kind of a cool idea. Yeah, so from the window here, so starting from this window, but one in, we can start to bring another one back. So something like this. I have no idea how this is going to turn out. I really don't. I just wanted to do something really out there. Just a completely different house to what people are used to on YouTube, because I think it can kind of get all the same thing all the time. And yeah, so maybe two in the middle here. I think this will work actually. So count two blocks, and then 1, 2, and then just 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, like that. So far that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Maybe let me have a look. Kind of looks like little bee wings, which I kind of like. So I think that would be perfect, because then we can just have like a little room. Send that to there, and that there, and then that, like that. So yeah, something like that. So it's just kind of like, yeah, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, and then you can just kind of, yeah, follow it up that way. It's probably the quickest way anyway. And then underneath here, there, like that. Hopefully that's the same as the other side. Maybe it's, yes. And then I kind of wanted to put like this weird kind of floating stone. Just kind of, well, floating there. Just in the middle here. Just kind of just floating there, you know. But behind that, it's kind of been supported by this. Yeah. Okay. And then we can add this going down. Like that. And then this going down from here. Okay, and then 1, 2, 3, 4, so it's level with kind of that stone, connects into that stone, goes to there, connects into that stone like that. And then we can have like a little kind of room thing here, an extra room even. Like that, like going across here, and then this kind of going to that point there, and this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 5 there, that going across there, and then just kind of bringing it up like that. So 1, 2, 1, 1, 1, like that. And then we can have kind of like, in fact, I wonder if it's worth kind of just filling it all in as a square and just seeing what this looks like. Maybe we could have that as kind of like the glass roof there. So we've got that little square there, and maybe get some bush going across here, and then just kind of like a normal window. I think I might go with the black stained glass for this window. Just got that modern sort of feel. Bit of the stone and everything mixed in. So like that. Yeah, something like that. So from this side, we're going to have to fill some of it in. And of course, when you come up here, you kind of need a doorway into this place. So maybe we could put a doorway here or something like that. You can pick where you want to put your doorway. And yeah, you could have some windows in these kind of little bits here. And of course at this top bit as well, we can fill that in. Falling down here. It's a bit of a strange house, this one. I get it, but yeah. For this end one, we can actually put blocks instead. And then we can put an extra... Nah, I think that'll do like that. And then we can fill these in. Maybe the stair going across there, and then fill this in. So it's kind of like part of the support. We could do the same for this one as well. So that stair goes to here. Then we kind of know where it's blocked off and where you can't go, which is down that way. But yeah. So fill in these bits here, because this is part of the thing anyway. So you're probably not going to want windows around that area. Have I just put a block out there? No. So filling these sides in. We've got a nice area for maybe storage or something up here. Maybe an enchantment place. This can go across, this going up like this. And of course, if you decided to go up the other way, you could probably put a door in here as well. So wherever we put the other door, so there. Two doors for each side, so you can get down from both sides, kind of thing. And yeah, get this. Maybe just to there, something like that. So we've got that, on the roof. I wonder if it would work better with that. Going across like that, maybe, so you can do that. But if you kind of like that gap out as well, you can do that as well. Doesn't really matter, really. Kind of silly little details. So yeah, what we've done here as well, so I'm gonna fill this in with glass across here. I'm trying not to speed loads of it up. I'm trying to kind of do it with you guys, so yeah, maybe something like that. A three window, 1, 2, 3, and then a 1, 2, 3, 4 window, something like that. So yeah, and of course we can bring that across and maybe add a bush there. But yeah, we've got a nice little kind of cool room, and then add the doors in. Yeah, so there you go for that bit. And yeah, on top of this roof here, we can actually get some bush going round. Probably best to go from about here and round to here, so we're not falling off this roof. We've got a lot of roof balconies and stuff. We can actually, no point in a window there, so might as well have it like that. Yeah, you can kind of keep it with the windows here. So obviously this will be the floor level, so let's see if the stairways kind of lead onto that. That would be a perfect place to kind of get in. If we can, that is the problem. If we can't, I will fix it. I will get a solution for us. So maybe one here. Maybe we could have a balcony hanging out the side this area, which would be the perfect place to kind of just wrap this round like that. And then we can get from onto this balcony into this room here. So we don't need that there. Perfect. And I'm going to do the same with the stone. So maybe just some stone size to make it look quite modern and nice. And yeah, you can even do it like this if you wanted to. Kind of have it like that and stuff. But I kind of like the full sort of glass sort of look. We've got a little bit more room here now, so maybe just that out there. And yeah, we're gonna do the same doors, so like three high, nice and modern. You can kind of just get in like this. Obviously, if you're gonna have this in survival, you can mix it up and make it a little bit different. Might make this window here a bit higher and then have it as kind of like just like that. Add my glass in. And yes, we can kind of get this floor in now. So this floor be here. Just fill it all in with the smooth quartz, makes it easier. Here as well, we can have a window, so we can have it just at that bit there. Maybe we could have two windows just in here. Let's have a look from the outside. Maybe a window just there. I think just the one window there. Maybe we could have another window here as well. So like two there. So we've got upstairs and downstairs covered with a nice window at the side there. Obviously for here as well, because it's kind of raised up, get some bushes there and bring that all the way to this side here. And yeah, this is where we can kind of bring it out to where it is in the thing here, kind of round it off, and then we can decide where would the best place be for a swimming pool. So obviously the entrance, we're going to have kind of like an entrance from here, so it's probably best doing it kind of here, so I can at least just walk straight in there. Maybe have some stone stairs coming up from here, just where we've actually got the entrance. And then the rest of it, obviously we can have bush going round. I might make it a bit thicker here so we can actually walk around the build. So maybe 1, 2, like that. And that just makes sense for that. And we can bring this bush round. And then we've got kind of 2 space between there. It's a perfect sort of gap between it. So yeah, right to here. So the back space here as well, we can just have that going all the way across here. So we can bring this out. Then, obviously fill that in. We're going to need at least 2 spaces like that. Get it like that. Imagine you've got a 2 space to kind of walk to this point. So maybe it'd be about there. And then you can grab your brush. But you can change this. This is just kind of like messing around with different angles and stuff, but just so long as you've got at least maybe 2 space to walk around the build, that's probably the best sort of size platform. But obviously I'm trying to keep in with a certain size and stuff, but yeah, I think that should be fine. Just getting a nice bush going around it like this, and then we can start to work on the back. I just kind of want to see what this looks like, and then we can have a look where's the best place to put a swimming pool and stuff like that. So maybe we could have stone pillars coming up the side here, which divides that bit. Obviously where we've got the stone pillars, we're not going to want a swimming pool in that area. Maybe not, maybe here would probably be best. Something like that there, maybe a swimming pool here, and then this bit here, you can even have it where it kind of goes down, I guess. Just kind of down into this area here, and then fill this in here. So you've got kind of different levels to your build, it's not all kind of the same. I'm going to fill all that in, and this as well. Like that. And of course we can fill this in. If you want a kind of back swim pool as well, you can do that. If you want it kind of like, as soon as you come into this area, it kind of goes down, and then as soon as you want to come out of this area, come out like that, and then you can just fill another layer of stone down here. So it kind of, yeah, gives your build different kind of levels, and I think it looks cool for it. So yeah, probably do this a bit better. /set stone. Okay, so yeah, like that, and then you can start to add more bushes around this area then, if I can jump up. There we are. Kind of like, yeah, something like that. Yeah, it's just gives it a nice look, I feel. So yeah, swimming pool there, this around here, fill that in with stone. And then you can put like a little patio area there or something like that. But it just gives it a few more levels. You kind of, you know what I mean. Let's get some water in here. /set water. So fill that with water. Probably get some blue in there or something. /set blue. Which will put like a blue wool or something like that. Yeah, and you can put a little diving board or something like that. Just, yeah, get some string. And then you can just put some carpet on top. Maybe some white carpet or something. So maybe 1, 2 will be enough. And then 1, 2. Place another one on top of there. You've got a nice little cool diving board. And yeah, this is kind of where you start to decorate the build with kind of like bits of bushes around. So maybe wonder what these look like. The compositor just anything underneath your things that kind of look a little bit different from the build, that gives it a little bit of texture. Do you know what I mean? So yeah, so we've got this down here. We can maybe just put a table and chairs down here, a little patio area, maybe kind of like something like this. Maybe if you get the, we'll probably use the redstone torches to be honest, but yeah, I'm just using the blocks and then some sticky pistons or something. And then I kind of like doing these ones where you kind of like just get an iron bar. You could probably put one in the middle as well. Iron bar like that. And then like a trap door of your choice. So you place a trap door on top and then one out like that. So when you close it, yeah, it goes like that. And then you can put a carpet on so it's not as thick. It's like a brown carpet or something like that. And it's kind of like one of those little chairs or something. But if you kind of like it like this, where you, yeah, you kind of, you get the idea of what I'm going for here. So yeah, that goes up like that, down there. Probably going to be a bit awkward, this one. Crouch in the air. This little table and chairs. And then of course you can add your decorations around, maybe get a cake or item frames and stuff. There's lots of cake. It's just a cake evening, okay? And then you've got your pots and plants and stuff. Add them about the place. Like what you would see on patios, you can change this up as well. So say if you wanted to get like a different texture, I don't know what texture was would kind of like stand out, something like that. You'll probably get that in a patio sort of design or something like this. Maybe some checkers and stuff that'd probably work well. And let me just kind of finish this and see what it looks like. Yeah, we can put them underneath the chairs as well. That would work. But yeah, you kind of don't want it too much. You kind of just want it kind of subtle, because that's what you would get in a more realistic build. You'd have more subtle floor plans and stuff. Yeah, I kind of like that. And then you would probably have pots and plants. Just have a look what's in your grandma's patio. Grandma knows the best. And little flowers like this and stuff, and just little details you can kind of add around the place. Maybe even little shelves by putting little shelves like that and just putting like lanterns on, turtle eggs and kind of outside lanterns. Yeah, you get the idea. Just to kind of make it a little bit more pretty. You can do the same as well with paths as well. So if you kind of want to make it a little bit different, so maybe just the strip that's actually going towards the build, have that in kind of like a different kind of colour. Change it up, experiment a little bit, see what kind of works, see what you feel would work. What I'm trying to decide what this is, diorite. So this is diorite, obviously in this texture pack is way better than the diorite in your pack, so you might have to choose something different, but yeah. And then just something with stairs would probably work. Stone brick stairs or something like that. Maybe just do the stairs in something a little bit different. You know, make it a little bit, you know, a little bit different. And get some flowers here, maybe a lantern. Maybe I can have some hanging lanterns from here. Might be probably something like that. Maybe a lantern here, and maybe an extra. I'm getting ahead of myself here, I realize, but yeah, if it gives people a little bit of inspiration for doing the outside, because I know I don't usually stick to doing all this, but I kind of wanted to yeah, at least do something, so you get kind of some inspiration and ideas. Yeah, like up here it's really plain, isn't it? So you can have like really tall plants, but just like two of them, and you can see how it can make a plain wall kind of just less plain. Really does kind of make a difference. I wonder if something like this on top of them would look alright or not. But yeah, if you're wanting kind of like little kind of windows, just kind of little two windows like that or something like that. So you've got upstairs windows coming out there as well. That adds to it. And yeah, but I think it's looking pretty cool. So let's have a look on the back. That's pretty awesome. I kind of want to keep this at that height for this lower level. So it kind of, it just looks cool. So yeah, bring it from here. This can be like an outside balcony for this top bit. Bring it round so it kind of works into there. I'm gonna have to crouch down for that bit. Yeah, so that comes out here. And yeah, so you can get in some bush and kind of like this bush would be round here. And then round to this side like this. Kind of end there. So yeah, you've got kind of a balcony. So for these you can have some kind of like big windows or something like that. If you want to take out some of the bottom there, so you kind of something like this, you know. So you can have loads of windows. If you kind of only want a few windows, you can take some windows out, start experimenting. Maybe you want something plain there because you want something on the walls on the inside, or so you can start to put some plants to decorate those bits. You kind of get the idea for it. Yeah, bring this to here, and then we can have this at this level like this, and then you can kind of have like I guess an indoor swimming pool or something. Bring that out extra, so like another little swimming area here maybe. Fill that in there, and that in there, and yeah, could have another swim pool there, I guess. Or you can have it as maybe a sugarcane farm. Might be quite cool. Just kind of like just a random sugarcane farm underneath here, and it kind of all the way goes all the way up to the top, so it kind of holds everything in place. So maybe something like this, maybe. Get some lights around this area at least, and maybe kind of like a three doorway here, and then we can just have the glass going across the top or something. Leave it kind of fairly open plan on the insides. Check all the windows would be all right. So like the windows over here, and of course for this bit in here we're gonna have to kind of take that out and just have that there like this, and same here as well. Bring this up, and yeah, I'm gonna have to replace that with a thingy one, so it kind of all joins together, I guess. And of course you can have kind of like this going around here, and then when it starts to get to this point you can have like a bit where it's you're walking on it, and yeah, have some stairs going up to this point. So maybe you'd want staircase going from here, and then you can kind of fill the rest with glass like to there. Maybe add some bushes on the inside, kind of like that, bushes at the side there. Maybe even stop it by a bush. So you've got your doorway down here. And yeah, kind of for the flooring you can fill whatever you like. I'm going to just use stick with kind of the blocks. I'm kind of thinking of people in survival, they might be just near one kind of area. So if we keep with the spruce, but obviously you can change the floors to whatever you like. I'm just kind of sticking with this for the ease of the tutorial, but people can still adapt it and turn it into something or however they like, basically. So yeah, just a nice floor plan like that. And of course we've got a little area here. We don't want to be falling out the stairs. Maybe you can have just two here, and then we've got an actual doorway here. And yeah, just I'll try and I do fly all over the place, but you kind of, I get excited with builds like this. I'm like, right, I'll put this here and here, and But yeah, that's how a lot of people ask me why have I got the patience for this. It's because I kind of fly. That's how I don't get bored, because I'm a bit ADHD, so I fly around a lot and I'm like, right, I'll do this and this and that, and I get quite excited about what I'm doing. I think that's super important, and that really helps, so that's probably why. I just kind of love the game, I guess. I don't know. Or I'm just sad that Friday. So yeah, I'm gonna put this here, maybe just have a full glass window here. Yeah, I think just a big glass window here would be pretty good, and then at the sides of it we can add flower pots and stuff. But you can have like a back door, so if you were wanting something like a back door, I would probably put a back door like here or something. Let's get these from the outside. Yeah, fill this in, of course, to here. So that'd be filled in. We've got this to get up onto our roofs, and here as well. We can do exactly the same as what we've done here, but just maybe just more here, sort of. Kind of like that, and then this going over the top here, and then just filling in the glass and having just kind of like a big open window. At least we can actually move around at the back here rather than the front, where we can't really get through there, but yeah. So yeah, you can have a big sliding window, just like a big open one, or you can stick to your small ones. So yeah, you can really adapt this build to what you feel is best. Just experiment with it. It doesn't always have to be exactly the same as what I'm doing it, but I try to do it fairly detailed and give people an idea, because there is always people that just kind of like exactly how I've done it. So yeah, I try to stick to that. 1, 2, 3, 4 maybe. 1, 2, 3, 4. And it's just got some cool little passages that you can kind of just get through. Maybe not that area, but yeah, you get the idea. You could probably put a passage from down there. Let's get that compositor back. And yeah, just lighting it up in different places, obviously, where you feel would work with the lanterns. So, like bits here and stuff, and just kind of decorating the place. And if you want to kind of just do stuff like this and just then add to it. But if you wanted to keep it plain, you can keep it plain. Add some extra windows in where you feel it is plain. Because that's like the perfect height there for that. But yeah, kind of like how this has turned out. It's rather nice. You can even take this out, right? Just fill it all in with stone, right? Get this to come out even more. And then just double this up here. Add more to it. Do you know what I mean? So I think something like that. I really like this house. Let's see. I was going to do some sugarcane down the thing as well, wasn't I? But yeah. It's got really futuristic sort of feel to this house. I kind of really like it. So yeah. See, this is why I kind of do them like this. Sometimes when you plan it and you just plan it out for ages, it doesn't always turn out the best. But sometimes just something completely random can end up turning out some of the your good builds. So yeah, there you go. Right, sugarcane. So yeah, I said I was going to do this, so I might as well do this to complete it. And then you've got an idea. So kind of like, yeah, just get some sugar cane and just place them where you can. Probably best there and there. And there and there. Just making sure you don't fall. And then just bring your sugar cane to the top. Obviously you can add like farms and stuff around. Farms, flower pots, whatever you feel would work best for your build. And you can really just go full in on it and do something that you feel proud of. So maybe keep the bottom in there, but we've got that. And I'm gonna kind of stick at it like that, but let's have a little look around the place, see if everything's in order and where we could add maybe some lanterns. So maybe a lantern here and here, that'd be a nice place for a lantern. And down here as well, you could maybe get some trapdoors and add some flowers. At least we can't have like no flowers at all, so let's get some grass blocks here, get some trapdoors of your choice, add some flowers in. Let's get some bigger flowers, maybe some of the lilacs or something like that. We've got some flowers in there, and I like that. I like how it's come out, and you can put some kind of railings on at the top, but for the actual thumbnail and stuff, it probably won't work for me, but yeah, you get the idea. But hopefully you got something from this build and you want to slap a like on the video. If you've only just come across my channel and you do enjoy the content, leave a like and make sure you subscribe and hit the bell button and all that other blah 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 stuff. But if you want to help support this channel even more, and maybe you could become a Patreon or something, I don't know, something like that. So anyway guys, I'll catch you later in the next video. Peace out, hopefully you enjoyed it. And if you do want a tutorial or an interior even on this build, right, if you want an interior on this build, I might go ahead and I might actually put that there actually, and I might do that, but I still need to do the other one. I do realize I haven't forgotten. I will get around to doing it, but I kind of need to plan it out. But I enjoyed building the houses. This is why I kind of don't do the interiors as much, because sometimes I like to just spend hours on interiors, and obviously you can't always do that. Hopefully you got something from it. I'll catch you in the next video. Peace out.